欢迎大家来到今天警方的记者招待会。首先等我介绍一下台上面的六位讲者先。而在中间靠左方的就是我们西九龙总区指挥官卓孝业先生。在卓 Sir 的左手边就是我们警察公共关系科总警司郭家全先生。在卓 Sir 的右手边就是消防处处理副消防总长总部梁伟乐先生。咁啊，梁 Sir 嘅右手邊，咁就係行動部高級警司汪偉純先生。咁跟住去翻啊，你哋大家嘅右手邊啦，咁就係有我哋警察公共關係科高級警司江永祥先生，同埋江 Sir 嘅左手邊，咁就有組織罪案及三合會調查科高級警司李桂華先生。咁啊，稍後幾位講者會先後發言嘅，咁跟住會有個發問時間。咁麻煩想發問嘅傳媒代表舉一舉手，講出自己嚟自邊個傳媒機構嘅。咁最多係問三條啊，每位。咁事不宜遲，我將個時間交俾阿 Sir。
各位香港市民，喺過去嘅一個星期，香港唔同嘅主要幹道都俾啲暴徒嚴重咁堵塞，全港嘅交通近乎癱瘓，不同嘅大專學府被暴徒霸佔，淪為兵工廠。馬路上大家都會見到。只有暴徒掘出的磚和被整斷的燈柱，香港已經是滿目瘡痍。我想我和全香港的市民都一樣，對於這樣的情況是感到非常之痛心。究竟我們還要容忍姑息這些暴徒的行為到何時呢？今天記者會的安排，我會首先請西九龍總區指揮官卓 Sir同大家講講關於香港理工大學嘅行動部署同埋一啲澄清，然之後我會歸納翻暴徒喺全香港嘅破壞行為，同埋我哋警方喺行動上嘅一啲數字。稍後就會交俾消防處嘅梁 Sir 同大家講一講關於危險品同埋有一單暴徒搶走犯人嘅案件。我首先交俾卓 Sir。
在昨天和較早前，理工大學一帶出現了很多不同的暴力場面，其中最令人擔心的是廣泛和大規模地縱火。我們準備了一條影片，我們先集中看一看理工大學一帶被暴徒嚴重破壞和焚毀的情況，請大家看一看片。
嫌疑人開始攻勢，向警方投擲汽油彈，密集式投擲，路面火光紅紅。警方舉黑旗和橙旗之後，以催淚彈還擊。加洛薩聖瑪麗書院和歷史博物館對開，煙霧瀰漫。黑衣人密集式反攻，防暴警察向前推進，黑衣人組成三陣，再發動攻勢，無間斷掟汽油彈，警方繼續以催淚彈對付，持續了超過20分鐘才暫停。
我 香港市民大眾在上一次可以安全使用紅磡海底隧道過海，已經是上個星期三的事了。自從那天起，理工大學對出的紅磡收費廣場一帶就一直被暴徒佔據，而港大的市民都不能夠再用那條隧道。而暴徒在更早的時候，即是上個星期一，已經佔據了理工大學範圍。而大家還記得的話，當日暴徒是在校範圍裏面大肆破壞、縱火，之後的幾日他們用聯群這樣練習怎樣去投擲汽油彈、使用弓箭。而在上個星期四呢，是曾經有人用弓箭呢上在柯士甸道執勤的警務人員。暴徒已經將理工大學變成一個兵工廠，大量製造汽油彈和用壓縮燃料造成的炸彈。其實理工大學聚集了一班暴徒已經超過了一個星期，而事情呢去到昨天也都白熱化。在昨天早上呢大概十點鐘左右，有一班熱心的市民呢自發去到理工大學範圍一帶清理暴徒用來到堵塞道路的雜物。我的理解是香港的市民容忍度已經到了極點，而暴徒呢見到市民在清理路障的時候呢，竟然是不斷地用硬物、汽油彈和曾經拉弓去襲擊和威嚇這些清理路障的市民。我有同事呢在當時時呢是分別被彈珠和弓箭射中，而其中一名警務人員呢仍然是留院。在過去的一星期，警方一直都只是在校園的範圍以外設立防線，但暴徒是目無法紀，不斷地主動衝擊我們警方的防線。而例如在星期六晚，暴徒曾經是離開了理工大學範圍，在七南道南近歷史博物館的對開向我們的防線是進發。而在昨天，我們見到的暴徒已經不再分辨你是不是警務人員，是向任何人進行攻擊。為了令到事態不會進一步惡化，我們警方在昨天上午11點半開始是透過不同的渠道呼籲市民不要再去理大的範圍。而我們昨天亦在下午的12時開始，每隔幾個鐘頭最少4次是透過社交媒體和新聞發布，要求在現場的人士立刻離開理工大學範圍。到了晚上大概9點半鐘左右，我們都一再呼籲留在理工大學裏面的人是循著北面的李兆基樓一個出口離開。而之後呢，我們警方才開始首輪的拘捕行動。我想大家應該都要想一想，在過去的一個星期呢，其實這班暴徒呢隨時都可以自由進出理大的範圍，物資亦都是源源不絕地運入去理大。去到昨天的晚上呢，其實我們已經給了充足的時間和充足的警告俾暴徒去聽從我哋警方嘅呼籲離開，但係有一啲暴徒仍然堅持係留喺理工大學範圍裏邊。喺咁嘅情況之下，我哋警方要採取行動。喺昨日嘅行動裏邊咧，我哋確實拘捕咗一批自稱係志願醫護人員同埋一批自稱係記者嘅人。這班人呢，他們是穿著著相關的一些衣飾的，但是警方呢的行動呢並不是針對個別人士的身份或者是職業，我們是針對 我哋係針對逗留喺理工大學範圍裏邊嘅暴徒。而喺昨日下午咧，我哋好清晰咁樣講過，任何進入或者逗留喺理工大學範圍裏邊並且協助暴徒嘅人咧，均有可能被視為參與暴動。而我哋亦都收到好確切嘅情報咧，知道有啲暴徒咧係以換裝變身，穿著反光衣飾去冒認記者或者係義務嘅急救人員，藉此希望逃避拘捕、逃避刑責。因此，我哋目前係會先拘捕所有身份有可疑嘅人，並會進行深入嘅調查。頭先我想講話有51個自稱係志願醫護或者記者人士咧，其實當中咧，我哋發現有12個人咧自稱為醫護，但係佢完全冇任何急救或者醫護嘅資格。而喺記者方面咧，我哋都發現咧有部分穿戴記者衣飾嘅人根本冇辦法出示任何嘅記者證明。在經過身份核對之後，其實我們發現有一些專業的記者，我們也將他們放行了。警方想在這裡澄清，第一，警方從來沒有主動攻入或者進入理工大學範圍，而是大批的暴徒在凌晨時分起一直在暢運道聚集，並且向我哋警方嘅防線咧，係投擲多輪嘅汽油彈。我哋警方需要進行驅散同埋拘捕。喺同事嘅追捕暴徒期間，個別嘅同事可能喺追捕緊嗰個暴徒嘅時候，係會有進入過理工大學範圍，主要係近出入口嘅位置。但係當完成拘捕之後咧，我哋都立即撤離，原因就係我哋都受到不斷嘅攻擊，所以我想澄清，坊間流言話我哋主動攻入去理工大學範圍嘅講法係唔正確嘅。另外，亦都有一啲坊間嘅講法，就係話警方一直呼籲喺理大範圍裏邊嘅人沿住 Y 座出口附近咧係離開嘅，但係同時我哋又向 Y 座出口使用催淚煙，阻止佢哋離開。事實嗰啲煙係裏邊一啲人將雜物放喺 Y 出口並且縱火，堵截嗰個 Y 出口，令到想離開嘅人不能離開。另外有一個指控咧，就話我哋今日咧早上咧喺理工大學嘅設施咧施放多枚催淚彈，唔容許理工大學裏邊嘅人離開。咁由今朝早8點開始咧，有一大批咧佔據咗理工大學嘅蒙面暴徒咧，佢哋係突然間咧由理工大學衝出嚟，並且咧衝擊我哋警方防線。期間咧，我哋發現多人係手持汽油彈。喺警告無效之後咧，我哋先至使用武力將佢哋驅散，包括施放催淚煙。而呢班人咧喺投擲咗汽油彈之後咧，亦都翻入去。佢哋嘅行動咧，事實令到一啲咧可能想和平離開嘅人咧係做唔到。另外第三咧，網上亦都有人咧傳言咧，警方是用火車將一些被捕人士送走的，那我想澄清是沒有的。而事實呢，昨晚呢當理工大學的南北橋分別着火的時候呢，濃煙呢是攻進去紅磡火車站，而火車站是一度需要疏散的。現在我們警方評估現時的形勢呢仍然是非常緊張，理工大學附近一帶呢風險是相當之高。我呼籲所有 而家留喺理工大學範圍裏邊嘅人，請你停止使用暴力。請你立即出嚟投降。我亦都呼籲所有支持使用暴力嘅人，請你停止使用暴力同埋停止支持使用暴力。現階段咧，喺九龍嘅尖沙咀同埋佐敦範圍，仍然有大規模嘅一啲群眾嘅活動喺度。我請嗰啲人盡快離開，盡快和平散去。警方一向致力希望能夠令所有群眾事件係和平、有秩序咁樣結束。我再一次呼籲所有人停止使用暴力，所有人停止支持使用暴力。我而家將我時間交翻俾阿郭 Sir。
在過去一個星期，暴徒在全港多區肆意堵路，掘起了磚頭，割斷了燈柱來做路障。大家都會見到有暴徒在中文大學的二號橋向吐露港公路、向無辜的道路使用者投擲汽油彈、投擲硬物，惡意癱瘓了新界的主要幹道。亦都有暴徒在理工大學的天橋多次破壞和堵塞紅磡海底隧道的設施。暴徒的這些行為已經遠遠超離了、背離了他們所說的公義。他們只是為了破壞而破壞，為了自己所謂的政治訴求，挟持了全港700萬的市民。行為是極度自私和卑劣的。過一個星期，我們見到一些市民已經無法忍受這些這樣的暴力行為，在多區自發地去清理一些路障，希望盡自己的一分力去為自己的家園、為自己的香港恢復秩序。但很可惜，這些暴徒已經近乎失控，在不同的地方肆意襲擊普通的市民，包括在高處向他們投擲這個燃燒彈，在街上對他們執行私刑。這些行為極度冷血和可恥，我們可以看一看相關的片段。
自發清理路障，拆除鐵馬又搬走長竹，十幾個黑衣人坐在路障前，有人拆除他們身後的路障。一個男人和黑衣人發生口角，其他市民隨即加入指罵黑衣人。爭執期間有人投擲汽油彈，在網上的片段見到汽油彈疑似在天橋掟下來。
你大隊出一段七行到南，亦都有人出嚟清路障。一班黑衣人由暢運道出嚟，要求對方離開。部分人拎住磚頭，有人衝前向清路障嘅人嘅方向掟磚。試圖襲擊其中一個人，清路障嘅人加入，一度拉扯同打掟磚嘅黑衣人。幾個黑衣人亦都介入，救走黑衣人。 過程入面，兩個青路障嘅人亦都受傷。
作為一個土生土長嘅香港人，實在好痛心見到香港變得民不聊生。暴徒嘅行徑幾乎係顛覆咗香港嘅秩序。市民每一日需要擔心嘅，除咗係暴徒嘅堵路行為之外，更加要擔心如果遇到暴徒嘅時候，會俾佢哋襲擊。另外，全港有幾百組嘅交通燈被破壞，不同嘅公共交通設施，包括港鐵站，大受影響，市民嘅出行嚴重受阻。究竟是哪一個破壞了市民的生活呢？有病人因為暴徒這些堵路的行為沒辦法去醫院應診，病人的食物、病人的樣本的緊急運送都受到嚴重的影響。與此同時，我們都見到暴徒的武器已經由磚頭、雜物演變成致命的武器，包括綁有鐵釘的石油氣罐、過千個的汽油彈、信號彈、弓箭和一些的腐蝕性液體。我們都有同事小腿中箭，支箭有15厘米，是插了他小腿上。如果大家試想，這支箭不是插在小腿，插在身體的心臟的位置，你可以考慮到個後果係幾咁嚴重。而當時被弓箭刺傷嘅呢一個同事，其實佢唔係執行緊防暴嘅工作，佢都冇防暴嘅裝備，佢係負責緊傳媒嘅聯絡，企喺大家記者嘅中間。亦都即係話，如果唔係佢中箭嘅，有可能係記者中箭。呢個根本就係企圖謀殺，是非常嚴重的罪行。另外，我們都有裝甲車著火，有記者被汽油彈波及受傷。難道這些就是暴徒口中的自由？我們可以看看片段。
面積理大同港鐵紅磡站的行人天橋起火，火勢猛烈，濃煙升上半空，多次傳出爆炸聲。起火範圍幾乎佔了半條橋，不斷有火舌跌到橋下。警方嘅武装甲车喺红隧对出嘅行人天桥向前推进，期间黑衣人不断系掟汽油弹。
到目前为止，有三所嘅大学，包括系中文大学、理工大学同埋城市大学，都已經同我哋報咗案，只有暴徒喺校園入邊藏有大量嘅汽油彈，亦都只有暴徒喺大學嘅實驗室偷走咗大量嘅易燃、易爆嘅化學品。警方係非常重視有關嘅案件，必定會嚴肅跟進同埋調查，保護全港市民嘅安全。另外，我想交代兩單開槍嘅事件。首先是17日的晚上，暴徒以汽車嘗試襲擊警員的一個案件。當晚約10時，警方在紅磡柯士甸道設立防線。當同事向七鹹道南方向推進的時候，有暴徒駕駛一架白色的私家車，蓄意從後撞向警員。在場警員發現之後，後方有車輛衝向他們，由於生命受到嚴重的威脅，一名警員向這輛私家車開了一槍，私家車立即掉頭， 並沿柯士甸道往尖東方向逃去。警方嚴厲譴責冷血暴徒這種仿效恐怖主義的行為。另一宗的開槍事件是在今天的凌晨，在尼敦道和佐敦道的交界，因為有參與非法集結而拘捕了的一名20歲中國籍女子，她因為頭部受傷，所以警方是為她安排了救護車送院，並由兩名的警務人員負責押解。但是在押解期間，大批的暴徒攻擊救護車並搶走這一名被捕人，而負責押解的警員就被這班圍困了在救護車裡面。暴徒向他們投擲石頭、磚塊、淋不明的液體，一名警員在生命受到嚴重威脅的情況之下開了三槍，初步相信是沒有擊中人。警方強調協助罪犯是嚴重的罪行，一經定罪，最高刑罰監禁十年。現在我跟大家更新一下拘捕的數字，警方經調整後的總拘捕人數是4491人，其中包括3395男、1096女，年齡介乎11至83歲，主要涉及的罪行包括暴動、藏有攻擊性武器、縱火、襲警等等。而在過去的週末，警方的行動一共拘捕了154人，包括103男、51女，年齡介乎13至54歲，主要涉及的罪名是非法集結、暴動和縱火等等。在使用彈藥方面，截至到今天的凌晨，警方在週末的行動中使用了以下的彈藥。11月15日星期五，催淚彈88發，橡膠彈19發，無用布袋彈、海綿彈4發。11月16日星期六，催淚彈54發，橡膠彈33發，無用布袋彈、海綿彈4發。至於在11月17日，即是昨日的使用彈數仍然是點算當中。截至今日的凌晨，警方在昨日的行動錄得7位的警務人員因為行動而受傷，而由6月至今總共有454個警務人員在行動當中受傷。跟住落嚟，我會交給消防處的梁 Sir 跟大家講講關於危險品和暴徒搶犯的案件。唔該，梁 Sir。
係，各位傳媒的朋友，咁過去幾日咧，香港各區都持續咁出現好多示威同埋暴力嘅事件嘅。示威者大多數咧都係用大量嘅磚塊、雜物去阻塞多條嘅主要幹道，甚至喺馬路上咧鋪上石屎，阻礙咗行車，阻礙交通，令到消防同埋救護嘅車輛咧未能前往召喚嘅地點執行呢個滅火、救援同埋緊急嘅救護服務。當中以尖東消防局、尖東救護站和九龍塘消防局暨救護站的影響最受影響。上個禮拜五15號至到今個禮拜日的17號，三日加起嚟咧，全港一共有38宗的火警召喚咧，係未能係達到消防處的服務承諾，即是在6分鐘之內係未能到達現場嘅。而緊急救護服務方面咧，三日加起嚟咧，全港一共有530宗係未能達標嘅，即係喺12分鐘之內咧係未能到達現場嘅。另外，示威者咧亦都不斷喺多個嘅港鐵車站、商鋪、街道大肆咁放火，又向警署咧投擲呢個汽油彈，造成嚴重嘅破壞。喺星期五同示威同聚眾活動相關嘅火警召喚數字總共有47宗，而緊急救護服務總共有14宗。 星期六火警數字是24宗，緊急服務是8宗。啱啱嘅禮拜日，琴日火警嘅數字是56宗，緊急救護服務是16宗。呢啲都是同示威或者聚眾活動有關嘅數字嚟嘅。喺琴日嘅星期日，喺香港理工大學連接呢個港鐵紅磡站嘅天橋被示威者縱火破壞，期間發生多次爆炸，火勢非常之猛烈。另外，示威者亦在理工大學的校園裏面和外面到處放火，以及向警方投擲大量的汽油彈，甚至我們看到是會用到橡筋或者大型工具去投擲這些汽油彈的。在網上的片段我們都留意到，有示威者因為投擲用這個橡筋或者大型工具去投擲汽油彈而令到自己都受傷的。我在這裡請示威者立即停止這種完全罔顧人命的行為，而受傷的人士亦都應該盡快去求醫的。另外，有些報道都指有些大學的校園裏面有化學品是被偷的。本署消防署重申，基於不同的化學品都有不同的危險性，包括易燃、有腐蝕性或者有毒的。不適當地使用這個化學品會對周圍的人包括自己造成嚴重的傷害的。在這裡我強烈地呼籲示威者要顧及所有市民的安全，切勿使用任何具危險性的化學物品。我們亦在這裡呼籲，如果有人是沾染到這些化學物品的話，是應該盡快將受污染的衣物除去，並且在可行的情況之下大量以清水去沖洗。如果大家在室內聞到一些刺激性的氣味的話，應該盡快離開這個現場，走到去室外面。如果大家在室外面聞到這些刺激性的氣味，應該盡快離開現場。如果是有需要的話，是應該尋求協助的。最後我亦都想交代一下發生在昨晚的一宗佐敦道和廣東道交界的有這個傷者被強行帶走的一件事件。昨晚的凌晨2:43，隸屬旺角救護站的一架這個救護車呢，就指派去前往這個佐敦道和彌敦道交界去處理一宗頭部受傷的緊急救護服務。在這架救護車在3:00左右到達了在佐敦道和廣東道交界的位置之後呢，由於前面有路障那些這樣的情況，所以呢救護人員需要徒步前往現場的。到達了之後呢，救護人員呢就發現了一名女性的傷者，救護員隨即為這名女性傷者呢進行包扎。跟住之後呢，救護員就將該名女性的傷者呢送上去救護的台床上面，並且由警務人員護送之下呢返去他那架救護車那裡。在護送過程期間呢，有大批 的人士呢聚集和尾隨住救護員和警員。當他們到達這個距離救護車大約50米後面的位置左右呢，尾隨的群眾呢開始情緒激動和指罵這個警務人員的。去到夜晚的大概3:09左右，三名救護人員連同兩名警員和那名的女傷者呢就到達了救護車的車尾。為了減少警員和市民的正面衝突呢，救護車的主管呢就給那兩名警務人員呢先行上去的救護車裏面。當警務人員到達了這個救護車入面之後呢，群眾人士呢就開始這個攻擊在救護車裏面的警員。他們將磚頭、雜物不斷扔下去的救護車裏面，亦都有其他的聚眾人士呢在救護車的兩側呢不斷推撞那架救護車，亦都阻止救護員呢將該名女傷者呢送去救護車上面。我們的救護員呢是嘗試將傷者去帶往一個安全的位置的，但是呢都被其他的群眾呢阻止，甚至將該名女的傷者呢就扯離開救護台床那裡。 主管救護主管亦都一度嘗試咧去刪翻嗰個救護車嘅車尾嘅，但係都俾包圍嘅群眾阻止。兩名救護人員最後尾翻翻去救護台床之後咧，就發現本來嗰名嘅女傷者咧已經不知所蹤啦。聚集嘅群眾咧依然喺救護車兩旁咧繼續去搖晃我哋嘅救護車。跟住我哋嘅救護同事聽到槍聲之後咧，包圍救護車嘅群眾咧亦都離開咗。最後我哋幸好咧，我哋三名嘅救護人員咧係冇受傷嘅。咁但係我哋再去嘗試喺附近去搜索去揾翻該名女傷者咧，都係揾唔到嘅。咁而我哋嘅救護車咧，亦都後尾咧係確定係損毀都好嚴重嘅。我哋消防處喺度強調咧，所有嘅傷病者，不論佢任何嘅背景，我哋嘅本處消防處嘅同事咧，都會一視同仁嘅，為佢哋提供最適切嘅救護服務。如果示威者強行帶走傷者嘅話咧，可能會令到個傷者嘅傷勢加劇，有機會嚴重到咧威脅到佢嘅性命嘅。咁我希望所有示威者咧停止呢一種對傷者造成第二次傷害嘅行為。我最後要特別強調咧，消防處會動用一切可用嘅資源咧，繼續會喺最前線為廣大嘅市民提供服務嘅。但係我哋希望市民留喺安全嘅地方，唔好參加所有違法嘅示威或者暴力嘅活動，更加唔好以任何嘅形式支持一啲堵路或者縱火呢一啲嘅違法行為。多謝。
跟住我會簡單總結一下，喺過去一個星期嘅三罷，無辜嘅市民冇車搭翻工被罷工，學校被停課，學生被罷課，店鋪受破壞被罷市，暴徒再次綁架了所有的香港人，犧牲了市民享受正常生活的權利。在暴徒用雜物堵路，癱瘓主要幹道的交通，在暴徒在大學裏面製造汽油彈和殺傷性的武器，是暴徒在校內縱火燒車，亦都是暴徒在高處用弓箭射人、投擲汽油彈。這些難道還不是暴徒的行徑？六月的時候，暴徒扔一些磚頭，我們說他很暴力。之後他們射鋼珠，我們都是說他很暴力。暴徒再用腐蝕性的液體，我們都是說他很暴力。之後他們出動這個汽油彈，初時是扔落地的，之後就燒了一些店鋪，說是裝修。當時我們都是譴責他們暴力。到昨天他們用弓箭去射警察，究竟我們還可以容忍這些暴力提升到什麼的程度呢？香港引以為傲的法治精神到底去了哪裡呢？另外我們留意到，在網上有人煽動其他人去參與暴動，亦都有人在網上聲稱會進行一些恐怖襲擊的行為，包括用汽車襲擊警務人員，用汽油彈襲擊警察或者紀律部隊的宿舍。我們必須警告這些暴徒，網絡世界絕對不是法外之地，我們一定會嚴肅跟進所有這些違法行為。我們香港警察必定會繼續在這個困難的時刻，盡心盡力地維持香港的秩序，維護法治都需要大家市民一起努力。我們很希望市民大眾都跟我們一起努力，去不要再縱容，不要再默許這些所謂的美化了的暴力行為，希望令香港可以盡快回復平靜，重歸正常。接著我會簡單用英文扼要地講回剛才的內容。 Over the weekend, Hong Kong was struck by widespread rioting as extreme violence descended on university campus and residential areas. Rioters also set fire to major transport routes and harbor crossings, leaving part of the city gridlocked for days. Most alarming, deadly weapons were used in the Polytechnic University, which has become a weapon factory as well as a refuge for extremely violent rioters. There are several potentially fatal attacks targeting the police. First, yesterday morning, one of our force media liaison council members was struck by an arrow outside Polytechnic University in Hong Kong. Without a doubt, this is a murderous act. There are many reporters in the same area. The arrow could have killed our officer or anyone in the surrounding. We express the strongest condemnation against this indiscriminate violence. Second, several rioters launched a vehicle ramming attack on our officer at around 10 p.m. yesterday. At that time, our officer were advancing through Chatham Road South, where rioters trying to ram a private car into them. To protect themselves from death or serious injury, one of the officers fired a live round at the car. He then fled towards Tsim Sha Tsui East. Such terrorist attack is again calculated to kill our officers. Although no one was injured in the incident, the development so violence has reached a critical level. Rioters has so intent to murder our officer at all costs. Third, in the lead up to another open fire incident, one 20-year-old Chinese female was arrested for taking part in a riot in Jordan and was taken onto an ambulance for treatment under police escort. The rioters then surrounded and attacked the ambulance and worst of all, helped the arrested female escape police custody. Afterward, rioters heard stone break into the police officers struggling on the ambulance. In response to the imminent life threat, one officer fired three live rounds. No one was injured. We must emphasize assisting offender is a very serious offense, liable to 10 years imprisonment. A university is supposed to be a breeding ground for young talent, but it's unfortunately become a battlefield for criminal and rioters. The PolyU campus in Hong Kong has turned into a weapon factory where an arsenal of weapons were made and stored. Offensive weapons like arrows, petrol bombs, metal balls, and bricks were launched from makeshift catapults mounted on the roof of the campus. One large gas canister, which looked like a self-made bomb, was also seen inside the campus. We also received a report from PolyU that several toxic and dangerous chemicals had been stolen from the laboratory. Among the stolen chemicals were highly volatile explosives. We must warn that the university campus has become a powder keg where danger is far beyond what we can estimate. For the deployment in PolyU, it's necessary and justified for police officers to take action in order to contain the violence and restore public order. As a whole, over the past week, our officers were only deployed in the periphery of university campus and exercised great restraint. We repeatedly appeal to rioters inside the PolyU to leave. However, all our warnings were ignored. Our message was loud and clear. The violence has escalated to rioting. Anyone who stayed behind may be liable to taking part in riot. We also have intelligence. Certain rioters disguised as first aider or medical officers but were indeed rioting. There's no way for us to verify their identity, so it's justified for our officer to make arrest. Here we must also clarify, we never stormed the PolyU campus. In contrast, those master mob gathered on Cheung Wan Road Beach and hurled petrol bomb at our police officers. These necessitated police dispersal and arrest operations. While individual officers have made arrests near the entrance of the campus, they retreat to their chat line outside the campus afterward. We must stress that we have always been looking for a peaceful resolution to the violent incidents. As long as these masked rioters give up their weapon, drop their weapon, follow police instruction, and shoulder their legal responsibility, the police have no reason to use force. In terms of arrest, police arrested in total 154 people, consisting of 103 male and 51 female, aged between 13 and 54 over the weekend. The offence include unlawful assembly, taking part in a riot, possession of offensive weapons, burglary, etc. In conclusion, Hong Kong has been crippled by violence and public fear for almost half a year now. It's saddening to see our society being torn apart. Hong Kong's rule of law has been pushed to the brink of total collapse as those masked rioters recklessly escalate their violence under the false hope that they can get away with it. We must make this very clear. Nowhere in Hong Kong is a lawless land. If someone breaks the law, regardless of where you hide, the police are duty-bound to bring offenders to justice. No excuse, no political demand can spare anyone from legal liability. Please join us to put an end to violence before it is too late.
好，問題時間，TVB 唔該。
各位 TVB 記者先知，想請問一下，想問一下依家喺理大嗰度嘅你哋嗰個策略啦，因為你啱啱都講過話，你哋施放催淚煙唔係話想逼啲黑衣人回到校內啦，咁我都想問一下，咁如果佢哋係冇作出任何嘅行動，咁冇用武器，咁和平咁行出嚟，你哋係咪都唔會施放催淚煙？而佢哋出嚟嘅話，係咪都會以暴動罪嘅涉嫌暴動罪去拉佢哋咧？呢個第一個問題。第二個問題就係因為依家見到佢哋都係不斷咁樣係嘗試衝出嚟，用一啲汽油彈咁樣。咁你哋亦都係用催淚煙，會唔會擔心時間持續一長，會造成一啲嘅大規模嘅流血事件咧？或者係甚至有啲人形容為港版嘅六四？你哋會點樣評價呢啲評論咧？你哋會點樣防止呢啲情況出現？最後一個問題就係有警員中箭，有一個 PPRB 嘅警員中箭受傷，想問一下因應呢件事，你哋會點樣去保障一啲警員嘅安全？點樣會唔會加強一啲嘅提升一啲嘅武力？而啱啱都提過，網上有人講過會發動恐怖襲擊，會唔會提升香港嘅嗰個風險？會唔會係提升咗咧？唔該。
首先會將頭嗰兩個問題咧交俾阿卓 Sir， 跟住第三題咧就交俾阿江 Sir。
TVB 記者的提問咧，就係有關我哋喺現場使用嘅武力嘅情況啦，同埋咧就係如果出嚟嘅人咧係會被捕係咩情況咁樣。咁同埋咧就講話，假如嗰班人咧係衝出嚟嘅話，我哋會點樣處理？咁其實兩個問題都係相關，咁我一次過合併去回答。首先第一，我哋希望件事係可以和平解決，所以我而家係呼籲所有人。放低你嘅武器，慢慢有秩序咁样行出嚟，让我哋可以处理所有出嚟嘅人。我哋系会用涉嫌暴动去拘捕佢。如果佢哋唔系尝试冲击我哋嘅防线，我哋系唔会需要使用任何嘅武力。咁我谂大家见到今朝都有不少嘅画面咧，系见到有好多人咧。是有秩序地走出來，亦都被我們呢是處理，包括呢是使用塑膠帶呢是將他們控制， 同埋咧集合咗之後咧，我哋再安排咧佢哋去一個安全嘅地方繼續處理嗰個拘捕過程嘅。咁呢個亦都正正展示出咧，我哋係相當之克制。咁我哋希望咧呢件事係一個和平嘅方式解決。所以我再一次呼籲，而家喺佔據喺理工大學範圍裏邊嘅暴徒，請你立即放低你嘅武器，和平有秩序咁樣行出嚟。咁我交翻俾第三個問題。
咁啊，對於有同事咁喺個事件裏邊受傷咧，我係感到相當之擔心啊！唔單止係我同事受傷，呢個仲係我嘅傳媒聯絡隊嘅同事嚟嘅。咁就其實佢喺個工作環境裏邊都係希望去協助唔同嘅傳媒機構嘅記者啊，佢哋喺個採訪嘅工作裏邊，甚至乎今朝早我嘅傳媒聯絡隊都喺琴晚同埋今朝亦都協助過唔少嘅，因為佢機構對佢嘅記者嘅人身安全又擔心，我哋派出我哋傳媒聯絡隊去協助或者去盡量安排佢點樣離開危險嘅地方。或者是他們有一些交更或者物資上的安排，我們都盡量協助，但是暗箭難防，到最後他們就被一些暴徒就用一些弓箭引致到嚴重受傷。其實在過去這五個多月的行動裡面，其實我們都一直都有去顧及我們同事的安全，所以我們在保護裝備方面，其實在這五個多月裏面也都是有不斷地因應回那個暴徒的暴力情況是作出一些改善和增加的。在這方面我們是會繼續去找一些適當的保護裝備給我們的同事。而在個武力使用方面，我們講了很多次我們的武力使用是反應性的，暴徒他不使用暴力的話，其實我們是不需要用任何武力。今次我們很不幸地見到暴徒那個的暴力程度是倍增，是增長得很快。於是乎其實我們亦都會在我們使用武力方面呢是作出相應的反應的。我在這裡是作出一個警告，暴徒你們放低你們的武器，放低你們的暴力，盡快出來投降。如果你們再去使用這些致命的武力的話呢，我們必然會用相應最低的武力去將你制服，不要嘗試挑釁我們。跟著我會找李 Sir 去補充一下有關這個恐怖襲擊的方面。
恐怖襲擊的方面呢，其實我們要跟回一句，就是我們香港警方呢是用這個聯合國這個反恐怖主義措施條例，即是在我們香港的條例裏面的第575條裏面所作的定義呢，是作為一個基礎的，就是說呢，如果是作出或者是恐嚇作出去針對人的暴力啦，或者是針對財物的損失啦，又或者是一些公眾人士的健康和安全構成危險，又或者是對一些電子系統的嚴重的干擾，或者是嚴重去干擾我們一些的機要服務呢，這個是一個基本的恐嚇啦。而達成一些什麼目標呢，就是希望去達成一些的對公眾人士或者是對個別的公眾部分的公眾人士呢，是一些的政治呢、宗教啦和思想上的影響。這個是一些基本的東西來的。那看下去呢，大家都覺得咦，為什麼好像很多都很接近的了喔。但是呢，我們在警方平核我們的風險的時候呢，我們有兩個元素呢是很重要的。第一就是說這些的組織性是否是否很高，而第二就是說我們沒有一些特定準確的情報呢是關於這些事情的。所以呢，現在我們的香港警方呢對於我們現時的恐襲的風險評估呢仍然 是在一個中度方面的。好，麻煩
星島，麻煩
星島記者。第一樣就想問翻，即係警方點解就包圍呢個理大校園咧？因為其實上週即係中大個衝突嘅情況，警方就話即係費事為咗正面衝突引起人命傷亡，所以就撤離中大二號橋啦。即係今次會唔會用同一個策略咧？ 同埋就住理大情況啦，因為頭先警方就話收到情報啦，理大入邊有人就著反光衣就逃避刑責同拘捕啦，就想問翻警方係幾時收到情報啦，由邊個講啦，同埋內容係點啦，有冇話查證咗之後咧釋放咗幾多記者同埋即係 first say 啦？第二樣就想問翻因為有一個商台嘅男記者仔周六凌晨就喺旺角街頭俾警察推撞，同埋懷疑被警察向佢背部射海綿彈啦，就想問翻個案件調查成點，由咩即係部門跟進啦，同埋涉事警員係咪已經停咗職，或者會唔會有啲處分咧？第三樣就想問翻警方使用嗰個長距離揚聲裝置嘅情況，因為琴日就警方就使用咗啦，有冇話其實即係警方可以確實話翻俾市民大眾同記者聽，其實嗰個使用次數啦，用咗幾多個裝置啦，係咪即係使用咗三秒咧？同埋因為其實琴日發稿嘅時候就話咧，使用呢個裝置係要傳達一啲重要嘅信息啦，咁其實即係琴日使用嘅時候就傳達咗咩信息咧？即係有咩信息只係需要傳達三秒，同埋即係使用呢個裝置對人體嘅影響禍害同埋嗰個使用守則。唔該。
咁就住星島記者頭嗰兩部分啦，關於理大嗰個包圍嘅情況同埋反光衣嗰個情報咧，我交俾阿卓 Sir 去作答啦。咁啊，跟住關於商台咧，我哋出咗聲明噶啦，咁阿江 Sir 都會有啲補充嘅。而第三個關於長距離嗰個揚聲裝置咧，我交俾汪 Sir 作答。我先請阿卓 Sir。
首先就住講話包圍理工大學嗰個狀況，咁我頭先都解釋咗，咁事件咧主要嘅起因咧，就係因為有人咧係去熱心嘅市民自發去清理該段咧被堵塞嘅道路，而引致咧大批嘅黑衣暴徒咧出嚟襲擊佢哋。咁我哋因此而展開咗一個咧幾長嘅對峙。而我哋當時嘅評估咧，嗰啲黑衣嘅暴徒咧係一路揾緊機會，係想衝出理工大學範圍咧製造廣泛嘅破壞。咁因此我哋一路係增援，到最後咧我哋成功將佢哋咧圍堵咗喺裏邊。咁而家現階段咧，我哋都係希望和平解決呢件事，因此我繼續呼籲所有嘅暴徒，請你放低你嘅武器出嚟自首。至於你講話反光衣方面，首先咧，喺呢過去六個月嚟咧，都唔止第一次，我哋見到一啲不知名嘅人士咧，穿著不同類型嘅反光衣噶啦。咁我諗呢一個亦都唔需要我同大家再去詳細嘅描述，而就住數字嚟講咧。先講反光衣穿著自稱救護員嘅咧，我哋發現咧，昨日我哋起碼發現有十二個係完全冇任何急救嘅資歷，亦都唔係任職喺任何嘅醫療相關嘅行業。所以呢啲急救員究竟喺協助一啲傷者嘅時候有幾有效咧？咁我都相當存疑。咁所以而家咧現階段，如果喺裏邊仍然逗留。選擇逗留在理工大學範圍裏面，假如你受了傷的話，請你出來，因為我們在尖東的救護站附近，消防處的同事已經設立了一個臨時的救護站在這裡，向你們提供協助。至於有關傳媒機構方面，我掌握的最後資訊就是在理工大學範圍裏面出來的人，經過我們傳媒聯絡主任的協調溝通，我們發現只有三個是完全無法提供任何證明，可以證實到他是屬於任何一個傳媒機構的。那三個人呢，我們都是以涉嫌暴動拘捕，其餘的新聞記者、專業的新聞記者，我們都是將他放行的。那跟著呢，我想第二個問題是
情報。
情報講了是
咁跟住我喺呢度就頭先阿江 Sir 有提及過，其實我哋喺早兩日已經出個聲明咧，就交代有關十一月十六號凌晨喺旺角發生嘅一件事件嘅。咁或者我講講當時嘅背景先啦。咁其實當日係十一月十六號嘅凌晨時分啦。咁當時有大批嘅暴徒咧，就喺旺角彌敦道一帶設置路障，投擲汽油彈、一啲懷疑腐蝕性液體同埋一啲嘅磚頭去襲擊我哋嘅同事。咁於是乎，我哋嘅同事咧就喺彌敦道一帶咧，就以用施放催淚彈嘅方法咧，就去做一啲驅散同埋一啲驅捕行動嘅。咁啊，當時咧件事發生嘅時候咧，就應該係我哋同事其實係準備將嗰個驅散行動咧，就擴展到去呢個砵蘭街嗰附近嘅。咁而當時咧就我哋嘅防暴同事就喺嗰度就遇到有幾位記者啦。 咁啊，個別嘅記者，即係當時咧就有個別嘅記者就同我現場嘅同事咧就有啲爭執。係啦，咁因為我哋同事其實主要都係想大家即係盡快離開啦，因為我哋成日都有講過喺呢一啲嘅驅散同埋拘捕過程裏面，如果大家有翻一個適當安全距離嘅話咧，其實對雙方都係一件好事嚟嘅。咁我理解嘅同事同我哋暫時嘅表述咧，就係、是、當時就係、是有個別人士就拒絕聽從警方嘅指示啦。咁跟住而過程裏面甚至乎係有個別嘅記者咧，就同我同事其實係有一啲嘅身體嘅碰撞同接觸嘅。咁最後咧，相關人士就轉身離開。咁咧就當時就同事就應該喺嗰度就發射嗰一枚嘅海綿彈嘅。咁樣當時佢嘅目的係為咗一啲嘅做驅散啦，定係希望喺雙方嗰度製造，即係當係一個嘅警告，同埋去製造一個安全距離啦。咁呢個都係我哋嚟緊咧會跟進嘅方向嚟嘅。咁而家我哋西九龍總區嘅同事咧，就會正式咁樣去深入了解同調查呢個事件。咁而正如我哋之前嘅通告有提及過，相關嘅同事咧，其實現在已經係進行休假嘅。咁啊，就住呢件事件咧，咁我冇其他補充。
涉及到第三條問題，你問呢個長距離揚聲裝置嚇，咁咧其實咧我哋講緊係尋日嚇，我哋咧就呢個裝置咧，其實喺我哋警隊引入咧，講緊係十幾年嘅啦嚇。目的咧就係話用一個有效嘅揚聲裝置啦，喺一個嘈雜嘈吵嘅地方咧，長距離咁樣將我哋嘅信息，重要嘅信息咧，去送到去一個特定嘅位置嚇，俾一啲目標嘅一群人啦，聽到我哋嘅指示或者聽到我哋嘅警告。咁啊喺尋日咧嘅情況咧，正正就因為有人喺理工大學附近射箭啦、彈珠啦，我哋警方咧需要保持一段嘅距離，咁樣去處理呢個事件。咁啊，如果我哋警方咧要有效咁將一啲警告同埋將一啲信息去傳送俾啊喺一個遠距離嘅一群嘅目標啊暴徒啊，希望佢哋可以同我哋合作嘅話咧，呢一個咧係其中一個我哋覺得可行而又有效嘅裝置嚟嘅。咁至於我哋用嘅時候咧，我哋發覺咧，除咗我哋俾警告嘅情況之下咧，似乎咧啲人都唔係好聽，而且咧仲有機會會引到其他人咧有更加激烈嘅反應啊。咁咧，所以咧，我哋決定咧暫時唔做呢樣嘢。不過我哋警方咧都會用其他方法，包括其他嘅揚聲器，雖然個聲咧好散，咁但係咧我哋都希望繼續啊喺使用我哋武力期間或者使用武力之前，盡量不停咁樣去俾一個警告，希望達到我哋嘅武力使用原則係一個必須而係最低嘅武力。當佢哋可以同我哋合作，唔再使用佢嘅武力，去配合我哋嘅指示嘅時間咧，我哋可以用一個必須最低武力嘅情況之下咧，去處理到呢啲示威者。咁呢個咧就係我哋用一個長距離揚聲裝置啊，調配佢哋去到前線工作嗰個背景同埋個資料啦。唔該曬。
我話其實係講一啲咩 message， 同埋即係對人體個影響，即係如果個裝即係嗰陣時用。
講個警告其實。正式嗰、那個即係仔細警告，叫人哋唔好喐，唔好射箭，唔好再衝擊警方。我諗呢啲大家都聽咗好多次，但係你話對人體嘅影響咧，其實我都唔係專家，係嘛？咁咧，但係我哋用呢個裝置係根據個裝置嘅供應商啊指示，安全地去使用嘅時間咧，我好相信達到呢個目的咧係安全而係有效嘅啊！唔該曬。
好，後邊係咪 out free？
Thank you. First question on arresting people claiming to be first aiders and journalists. What do you mean by you're arresting them before what you said you have no way to confirm their identity that you just said now? Because in the same way, they could be genuine first aider or journalists. Meanwhile, we see officers pointing guns at our colleague, our THK reporter. Does that mean that journalists and voluntary paramedics could be targeted at the sites, undermining press freedom and humanitarian principle? Secondly, some online footage showing some officers seeming to be escorting a group of black-clad men onto a train that runs to that could reach the border. Wondering if you have seen that and if that's true. Thirdly, how did you reply to the Poly Uni Technic University management on their calls to end this peacefully? You keep on saying people that they should surrender and come out. Any other ways that you think you can end these clashes at the Poly University peacefully, other than asking them to surrender? Thank you.
For the first and the third part question regarding the Polytechnic University, I will invite Mr. Chuck to answer. And then regarding the rumors about the online footage, I will pass it to Mr. Gong. Chuck, please.
Your question is about the arrest of so-called first aider and the journalist. And you did mention something about officers using their weapon pointing at them when they were leaving the Polytechnic. And you mentioned something about press freedom and humanitarian consideration. First of all, we have no way to identify who is a first aider and how to qualify an individual as a first aider. In our practice, only the fire services department are qualified first aider. So they will provide the best medical treatment to anyone in need. And as I already mentioned, among those dressed like a first aider and claimed to be a first aider, we found 12 of them has no relevant qualification, and they are neither the employee of any medical or treatment center. In that sense, I'm very worried the standard they apply on any person in need. So, with the assistance of Fire Service Department, we have already set up a temporary first aid treatment center at the Tsim Sha Tsui Ambulance Depot, which is in the close proximity of the Polytechnic. If anyone within the campus consider in need of medical treatment, please come up. We will facilitate. And as to journalists, we already deploy our FMLC. They have the least protection, and one of them already suffered a very serious injury when doing his duty to try to facilitate press freedom. I think we have paid the price. If you talk about my fellow officers holding the cordon line, there are lots of things coming in, including something beyond your imagination. We have seen petrol bombs coming in, corrosive coming in, some metal bearing coming fired by slingshot, arrows. I think it will be wise for the officers to take precaution and use their weapon against anyone until, I'm not saying that use, I'm saying that use the weapon point to someone until they could consider safe to off guard. And that's why I urge all the professional reporters or press or journalists, please cooperate with us, comply with our requests. We need a safe distance to make assessment. Please at least keep a distance of 5 steps away from us when we are dealing with any incident, including handling of prisoner. I think you will recall I have a sergeant with his neck stabbed by an individual in close range. I don't want that happen again to any one of my fellow officers, and I don't want that happen to any one of you. As my appearance in the last press conference, I already say that for press, do not mingle or mix between us and the writers. Because the situation in Polytechnics is really tense and really dangerous.
I hope you could understand some of the officers need to take the precaution. And I also, once again, saying that we respect freedom of press and we will continue to deploy our FMLC officers despite of dangers to assist you to perform your duty on the field. But please watch out where you're standing. Do not stand within the firing range of the radar, and do not stand within the line of sight of our weapon. Please move to a position where you could safely cover the incident you want to report on. And as to how to resolve this incident peacefully, you suggest to me, other than asking them to come out to surrender, is there any other ways to do so? First of all, I would say they have committed grave crime. They have used lethal weapons. They have launched deadly attack, not just to my fellow officers, but also to other members of public who come or who came to simply want to remove the debris or barricade from the street. At least they could live in some sort of normality. I think this is a very humble request from those residents in the nearby vicinity. So these rioters, they are also criminal. They have to face the consequence of their act. Other than coming out to surrender, I don't see at the moment there's any viable option for them. But I could assure we have the ability, we have the resolve, we have the capability to peacefully end this. So don't try their luck. Please come out, surrender to us. You will be treated fairly and you will be facing a fair trial. This is the rule of law. That cannot be compromised. I'm open to any other suggestion that could end this soon and peacefully. Thank you.
Okay, before I go into detail on the incident happened on the track, I would like to supplement a little bit on the first question relating to whether the some reporters were pointed by guns, etc. Since last evening, as an officer in PPRB, I received a number of calls from different media organizations expressing their concern about the safety of their reporters in the Polytechnic University. Because, as you all could watch from the TV, how violent were the rioters in the past 2 days. So the PPRB had paid much effort to assist those reporters who have concern on their safety to leave the Polytechnic University. However, when the rioters knew about which exit or entrance the reporters will leave through which entrance or exit, these rioters will initiate attacks there at that spot. So our officer, our PTU officer or our uniform branch officer encountered great difficulties to ensure the safety of that exit or entrance to facilitate those genuine journalists to leave Polytechnic University. As mentioned by Chuck Sir, our officer had to take a lot of precaution measures so as to ensure the safety of our officers as well as those reporters. I think that's why our officer will stay on guard with their firearm or their long barrel, so as to ensure that the one who leave Polytechnic University were genuine journalists, but not those rioters disguising themselves in yellow vests, etc. And that's all I would like to supplement. Concerning the incident happened on the track, actually, we receive information from the MTRC Incorporation that around 20 rioters tried to escape from the Polytechnic University through the track of the Hong Kong MTR station. And therefore, we deployed some uniformed branch officer to proceed to Hong Kong rail station from the Mong Kok East rail station. And we successfully stopped, I could not remember the exact figure, I think 10 odd rioters at the track. And on the track, the only transportation that we could arrange to take these arrested person away is to arrange a train. So the MTR facilitate us to take all these arrested person away with a train. And I think that's it, what had happened on the track of the Hong Kong rail station. Thanks.
As far as I know,
they were taken to a nearby rail station where we could arrange our own transport to take all these arrested persons to the police station for further processing. Thanks.
Gentlemen sitting on the second row.
啊、各位好，我香港卫视的想提一个跟禁蒙面法有的问题啊，就是高等法院今天裁决说禁蒙面法违宪，理由就是紧急法绕过立法会，赋予特首一个不受约束的立法权利，这样就是违背了基本法。那么我们看有立法会议员说这个法律是让局势升温，同时我们看到了就是一个半月下来，警方是以违背了这个禁蒙面法为指控，拘捕了大量的人，所以就想问问，就是你们认为这个法律到目前为止是帮助了止暴制乱，是帮助了像这个警方的工作吗？然后呢，接下来没有了这个法律就撤回了以后，你们的策略会发生一些什么样的变化？谢谢。
呢条问题会交俾阿李 Sir。
我哋都有留意到咧，今日係有一個嘅裁決啦，就係、是、關於係禁止蒙面法規入邊嘅司法覆核嘅。咁咧就頭先記者咧都有簡略講到一啲嘅佢入邊嘅內容啦。咁我哋咧亦都想有一啲嘅發言，或者我哋有一啲嘅關注咧，就喺個裁決入邊嘅。第一個咧就係話咧，我哋發覺咧佢都有提及到咧，就係喺蒙面法規第三章入邊咧，佢所有講嘅公眾活動入邊嚟講咧。法庭咧亦都覺得咧，依一個嘅要求咧，依個嘅事項咧，其實係咧係達到一啲嘅正常嘅社會目的，係有啲關聯性嘅，即係話咧係有一啲嘅需要啦。而第二樣嘢咧，我亦都發現到嘅咧，佢亦都好特別指出咗咧，就係話喺佢嘅三條，即係我哋嘅蒙面法入邊嘅3(1A)入邊咧，佢有講到就係話身處喺非法集結時候嘅使用嘅蒙面嘅物品咧，亦都咧係冇符合到超出到依個合理嘅需要性，即係話咧簡稱嚟講咧，佢咧係符合咗嗰個嘅相稱性嘅標準嘅要求嘅。咁但係當然呢個法庭咧係對入邊呢條法規入邊咧係有一啲嘅睇法啦，所以咧我哋咧係身為咗呢個嘅主要嘅執法者咧，我哋咧係一個比較穩妥啲嘅做法咧，我哋係會由現時開始咧係會暫停有關呢個禁止蒙面法嘅執法嘅。咁咧就等到咧有再有進一步嘅發展嘅時候咧，我哋先去決定點樣去處理呢樣嘢。 咁如果你話回顧翻究竟呢個嘅蒙面法是否係有幫助嘅話咧，我哋身為呢個執法單位嘅話咧，我哋覺得係有幫助嘅嚇。咁啊，因為除咗係令到佢哋啲人唔能夠喺個面罩之下咧為所欲為啦，亦都咧，譬如話大家都可以喺一啲文獻啊，或者喺啲上見到咧，令到佢哋如果係個真面目示人嘅時候咧，係會令到佢哋咧。去好妄意去犯法嘅決心咧，係低咗好多嘅。嗱，依啲係我哋一啲嘅發現咯。咁至於我哋亦都咧，頭先記者話咧，我哋係拘捕咗好多人喺呢個十月之後。咁我可以俾一啲數字大家作為參考。其實我哋本身咧，對於個無辯法嘅使用咧，係都係幾係好保守嘅。其實咧，我哋喺到十月到而家嘅時候咧。淨係拘捕係喺禁止無面法規入邊嘅人士咧，只係有三單，乜嘢都冇嘅，淨係係話佢係喺無面法規入邊干犯咗有一啲嘅條款嘅話，只有三單，而其中咧只係有一個咧係俾我哋落案控告咗。咁呢一位嘅人士咧，都係未到呢個審訊嘅階段嘅，咁所以咧，我哋咧會喺較後嘅時間咧，我哋會同律政司咧去商討一下，究竟應該係點樣處理呢位嘅人士，其餘嗰啲嘅被捕人士，我哋都會一併去處理嘅。好，唔該。
下一位，明報。
第一條想問翻消防嘅兩 Sir 嘅，想問翻尋晚至傍晚六點打後咧，你哋接到有幾多嘅白車召喚、緊急救護召喚係由理大發出，但係白車係冇辦法去到 Cordon 嘅現場入邊嘅，究竟有幾多單咧？同埋你哋估計喺理大範圍現場入邊究竟有幾多傷者？最嚴重嘅傷勢係點樣樣？有冇可能係因為失救致死咧？另外一方面想問翻卓 Sir 嘅，想知道翻喺理大入邊嘅圍困嘅策略。琴晚係截至到今日嘅下午兩點半，先至有紅十字會嘅人員係俾入去嗰個封鎖範圍入邊去拯救一啲入邊嘅可能嘅傷者。咁點解琴晚成晚會封鎖曬所有嘅幹道，白車可能係去唔到，救護人員、義工嘅人士係冇辦法入到去。有啲人喺入邊係低温症嘅，有流血嘅，都冇辦法得到適切嘅救治。點解會發生啲咁嘅事？警方嘅目的係點樣樣咧？你哋既然唔入去拘捕人，咁但係又在外面包圍，究竟你的目的是想怎樣呢？另外就想問回武器使用的方面，因為看到昨晚是即使用了很多從未見過的即一些高致命致命的武器，包括一些是長槍，好像 AR-15、MP-5 一些可能是閃光彈、震撼彈，又或者是一些有 sniper 的出現，為什麼會安排這些這麼高武力程度的人員去用這些武力？究竟香港是不是已經到達內戰級別？你們是不是用對付恐怖分子的方式去對付香港的示威者？麻煩
我先請梁 Sir 講講消防方面。
好，多謝明報記者。我第一條是關於消防在昨日星期日我們消防收到多少個緊急救護服務的召喚是在理工大學裏面的，其實相關的數字我們還在整理中，我們初步去看昨日17號星期日全日呢在理工大學裏面呢只有兩宗的緊急救護服務我們收到的，今天是再有一些的，不過相關的數字呢我們要再整理好才再可以通知那麼多位傳媒朋友。你問第二個問題是估計在浸會大學裏面有受傷的人士和傷勢的，咁我喺呢度我係冇辦法去估計裏面有幾多受傷的人士啦，或者佢哋嘅傷勢嘅。唔該。
跟住請阿卓 Sir 答答關於你睇。
明報記者嘅提問就係話喺兩點後咧，先至有紅十字會嘅志願急救人員咧進入。咁明報記者聲稱佢掌握咧，裏邊有啲人係有低温症啦，或者係其他類型嘅一啲症狀需要協助。咁我哋又冇進入去協助佢哋。咁你大概意思係咁樣係咪？好啦，首先第一，理工大學我哋喺外圍進行一個封鎖，從來任何人都可以行出理工大學範圍。我一路都係呼籲緊，由昨日到依家都係呼籲佢哋行出嚟自首。如果佢哋行出嚟自首嘅話， 而我哋又發現佢有醫療需要嘅，我哋係會安排。我頭先都講咗，今日亦都得到消防處嘅協助，就喺尖東嘅救護站咧安排咗一個臨時嘅緊急提供醫療服務嘅地點。咁所以如果你掌握嗰啲人係有低温症或者其他類型嘅醫療需要嘅話，咁我呼籲嗰啲人而家立即出嚟，我哋係唔會阻礙到佢得到適切嘅醫療照顧嘅。至於第二，我哋點解選擇唔進入去？首先第一，我哋嘅評估，而家理工大學範圍裏面係有大量嘅武器，有不少係燃燒或者會爆炸。如果我哋選擇進入去，第一對我自己嘅同事相當之危險。第二，如果我哋要使用武力先至能夠再制服裏面嘅人，大家嘅傷亡都可能係好嚴重。我講咗，香港警察係希望呢件事能夠和平解決，所以武器喺佢哋手上。如果佢哋放低武器，離開佢哋呢個範圍，我哋可以大家和平去處理。呢個選擇權喺佢哋手，我唯一嘅選擇係我暫時冇計劃攻入去，因為暫時我睇唔到有一個迫切我嘅需要咁樣做。至於你講話，我哋使用嘅武器裝備升級，首先第一，你頭先描述嘅嗰啲武器，我哋一向都有，係我哋嘅常規制式武器嚟嘅。至於你描述嘅一啲狀態，我會同意而家香港嘅情況係好混亂，我會同意而家香港嘅市面係好差，我會同意一樣嘢，而家香港有啲地方有啲人係目無法紀。正正喺我哋開緊記者招待會嘅時候，出面尖沙咀一帶仍然有大量嘅群眾喺度堵路、襲擊、破壞銀行、放火，無所不用其極，完全肆意罔顧法紀。我哋會使用適當嘅武力去對付佢哋。至於你提到我哋有啲同事有一啲專長能力，包括所謂你用嘅字眼係 sniper， 咁中文係狙擊手。我哋有專業嘅訓練，我相信我哋以往飛虎隊出勤，大家都見過。我哋從來都有呢個能力，如果有需要嘅話，我哋會使用。而家目前咧，理工大學嘅狀態，我嘅評估嗰個地方係非常危險。佢哋不停喺網上呼籲，要求好多人入去支援佢哋。我請大家唔好去。我亦都好擔心，如果有一啲市民懷住一個熱誠去幫助佢哋，可能會俾佢哋扣住，成為人盾。所以我想請大家，無論係乜嘢原因，唔好進入去理大校園。如果你知道理大校園裏面有任何人有任何的醫療需要，請你聯絡我們警隊，我們會盡量去安排，嘗試安排那個人離開出來接受適切治療。那我要講的咁多，
或者我做少少補充，其實在我們使用武力的原則，當然汪 Sir 是一個專家，大概每一個警務人員都知道，我們使用武力的目的是要制止對方的暴力行為，亦都係希望能夠保護到我哋自己同事嗰個嘅人身安全，同埋喺現場嘅市民或者係牽涉嘅記者嗰個人身嘅安全，亦都係因為咁嘅緣故，所以先要製造一個安全嘅距離。咁呢啲嘅原則點解我一路講咧？喺我廣告都有講過，喺過去呢半年入邊，由六月份呢啲暴徒初係用磚頭，跟住之係用鐵枝、鐵棍。跟住之後係汽油彈，再跟住係用弓箭呢啲致命嘅武力。如果佢哋唔係用呢啲咁樣嘅致命武力嘅時間咧，我哋唔需要提升我哋一啲嘅武力嘅戒備。但係呢度我希望呼籲翻香港嘅市民，對於呢啲不斷咁樣提升嘅暴力行為，一定要說不。如果我哋繼續默默咁樣去容忍佢哋，其實係縱容咗呢班暴徒嘅行為。 係滋生更加多嘅暴力。所以我希望廣大嘅市民要認清呢啲暴徒，佢哋使用呢啲咁樣嘅暴力，已經去到一個咧無法無天嘅階段。如果大家再唔一齊去說不嘅話咧，香港嘅社會真係會係滿目瘡痍，大家都唔想再見到。
CNN.
Hello, thank you. So, you said that you have no plans either clearing Poly University or making mass arrest. So you're waiting for the people to come out and drop the weapons and come out and surrender. So that's the first question. And are the police prepared to kill at the university? And we have seen long-range assault rifles, and do they have live ammunition? Are the police aware of underage students on campus? And is the police refusing Ted Hui's request to escort them off-site at PolyU? Do you understand?
Can you repeat the last one?
Last question. So you are aware there are people, underage people, at the PolyU campus. Is police trying to escort them off the site, out of the site at the PolyU, from the PolyU, instead of arresting them?
I will now invite Mr. Chu to answer the questions.
The CNN question is about our strategy at the moment. The police aim to resolve this incident peacefully. So our strategy at the moment, we continue our cordon, we continue to persuade those rioters inside to come surrender. And certainly, there are always other tactical options available. We will, and we have, the capability to execute different options. However, at the moment, we shall continue to persuade them to come out. And you mentioned about we are having long barrel weapons, including rifles. Are they fitted with live ammunition? And whether we have some sort of orders on using that weapons, is that right? First of all, we are police officers. We aim to use our weapon to stop and control the individuals. This is our aim. And as to the choice of level of force, including from a simple presence and verbal challenge to the use of deadly weapon, there is a continuum. And all our weapon, if they are being put on field, they are ready for use. They are fitted with live ammunition, including, not limited to, our long barrel weapons, our less lethal weapons, that means smokes, beanbags, super sock, or rubber, also our officers' sidearms. They are all fitted with ammunition. And for live rounds, it's only those I mentioned. And for less lethal, you know that our weapon is also clearly marked. I would say we keep our option open. I would warn the writer, don't test our bottom line. I have one fellow officer shot by arrow already. This is a very long-range weapon used by the writer. And if we have to respond, I believe the only option is to use deadly weapon. Because arrows are lethal. However, at the moment,
My tactics is to move back my cordon line, make it out of range of the arrow. So I would urge those writers, do not try to escalate their level of weapon or violence. We have the capability. I will once again urge them to come out, surrender, as if they always claim they want to fight a better future. Then please come out and face the consequence of your action and uphold the rule of law of Hong Kong, which is one of their demands. I think you also mentioned something about whether there is any underage individuals within the polytechnics. I have no concrete evidence or information at the moment. Okay. Then I would appreciate your reporter try to persuade them to come out. Right? If not, it would be impracticable for us to send a team to try to identify all those masked individuals. Who are you? How old are you? I think it would be asking too much to risk my officer's life to go in and try to identify one individual. I'm not talking about saving Pai Ryan. At least he wants to be safe. So if your reporter come across any minor inside, please ask him to come out. Please.
Hey.